Hi everyone, it is my pleasure to be with you in the International Population Data Linkage Network Conference, and I am pleased to present my research on mental disorders, subsequent suicide events in a representative community population in Canada. Globally, suicide is a huge public health problem. It is the 10th leading cause of death, representing 11.4 suicide death per 100,000 population. Looking specifically in Canada, it is the 9th leading cause of death for overall population, representing 10.3 suicide death per 100,000 population. More importantly, suicide is the second leading cause of death for youth and young adults in Canada. Existing research evidence shows that mental disorders are associated with suicide, meaning that people with mental disorders have increased risk of suicidal attempts and death. However, the evidence is mostly based on the studies with cross-sectional study design. That is, cross-sectional collection of data on mental disorders and suicide events, which has limited ability to investigate the temporal relationship between exposure and outcome. The evidence was based on the studies that collected the information on mental disorders and or suicide using psychological autopsy. This type of data are vulnerable to recall bias due to the retrospective nature of data collection, and that threatens the validity of research findings. Also, previous studies were mostly conducted in the clinical sample admitted to psychiatric inpatients. Studies based on clinical samples are vulnerable to selection bias since they overrepresent people with more severe illness. And suicidal ideation or risk is a common reason for admission to clinical services, which limits the generalizability of research findings. Therefore, we examine the pattern of association between mental disorder and suicide events in a community sample that is representative of the Canadian household population. To achieve this kind of objective that aims to fill the gaps in previous research, as I highlighted earlier, requires data sources linkage, particularly survey data to hospitalization and death records. In line with that notion, we conducted a retrospective cohort study that used a probabilistically linked three data sources, the Canadian Community Health Survey 2002, Canadian Vital Statistic Database 2000 to 2011, and Discharge Abstract Database 1999 to 2013. The Canadian Health Survey 2000 included 37,000 sample aged 15 years or more from Canadian provinces and territories representative to Canadian household population. From the survey data, we obtained data on sample characteristic and mental disorders, including major depressive disorder, bipolar disorder, anxiety disorder, and substance dependent, which were measured by composite international diagnostic interview instrument. Then survey data were linked to Canadian Vital Statistic to obtain data on their death records, including death due to suicide. After that, the survey data were linked to Discharge Abstract Database to get data on their hospitalization for suicide attempts. We included hospitalization for suicide attempt or death due to suicide in our definition of suicide event, which were identified using the ICD-9 and ICD-10 Canadian modified codes for self-harm. These more codes were validated and recommended by the Statistics Canada. We excluded survey sample from Canadian province, Quebec, as the Discharge Abstract Database does not include hospitalization data from Quebec. Finally, we analyzed 27,000 survey sample for our study. We use time to event survival regression analysis. Survey participants who remain alive and were not hospitalized for suicide attempts before the data linkage date, December 31st, 2011, were censored at that date. Competing risk regression models that adjusted for competing risk, other cause-related death, were developed to estimate hazard ratios and 95% confidence interval. The models were also adjusted for age, sex, marital status, and educational level of the survey sample, as these variables were associated with both mental disorder and suicide events. As this model did not meet the Cox proportional hazard assumption, whether the effect of mental disorder is constant over time, then the models were stratified by time to event cutoff 4 years. As we know that the risk of suicide attempt and suicidal death differs by male and female, female are more likely to attempt suicide, but male are more likely to die due to suicide. So we performed sensitivity analysis to compare the hazards for suicide attempts and suicidal death to check whether our data holds the same pattern as we see in the literature up to now. Survey sampling weights were used to ensure the representativeness of target population. Let's now take a look at some findings of 27,000 survey respondents eligible for this analysis. 0.41% had suicide event, hospitalized for suicide attempts, or died due to suicide. A high proportion of respondents with suicide events were younger, single, or previously married, including widow, separated, or divorced, and had post-secondary education. As shown in table here, the distribution of mental disorder was different by their suicide event status. Of those who had suicide event, about 16% had mental disorder, 14% had bipolar disorder, and approximately 16% had substance dependence. This slide shows the pattern of association between mental disorder and subsequent suicide. As we can see here, overall, all mental disorder were significantly associated with an increased hazard of suicide. The increased hazard of suicide event was distinct across mental disorder. As we could see here, that the hazard ratio for bipolar disorder was almost 17, whereas it was about 4 for major depressive disorder. Importantly, based on the stratified models using the time to event cutoff 4 years, the adjusted hazard ratio of suicide among those with major depressive disorder, anxiety disorder, and subsequent substance dependent were different over time. For this disorder, the increased hazard of suicide event was smaller after 4 years. For example, hazard ratio for depressive disorder was 6 up to 4 years, whereas it was 2 after 4 years. However, the strongly elevated hazard ratio associated with bipolar disorder, which was approximately 16, remained unchanged over time. Our findings confirm that mental disorders are associated with suicide events in a community representative sample. Our finding adds our understanding that the risk of suicide declines over time after a past year diagnosis of major depressive disorder, anxiety disorder, and substance dependent, but remains persistently elevated over time for bipolar disorder. From the clinical perspective, the findings underscore the importance of management strategies employed soon after the diagnosis of mental disorder. From the research perspective, our study should encourage future studies to focus on examining intervention for suicide prevention in community-based samples. From the data linkage perspective, it is important that when countries do national surveys, they should routinely link the survey data to other data sources as a means to enhancing the value of both data sources. The data linkage should not be limited between administered data sources. It should be expanded to survey or surveillance data sources. This allows us to answer our research question more completely and meaningfully, which is not possible in many situations using either of those data sources. Now, I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge the support I got from the co-authors of this research. It was a great pleasure working with you all, Dr. Scott Patton, Dr. Amy Metcalf, Dr. Andrew Bullock, and Mrs. Jenny Williams. And dear listener, I will be pleased to receive any questions and comments from you regarding this research if you have. Thank you very much for listening and have a good day and stay safe.